Hey guys, you're most welcome to this new video tutorial with OSP Pro. Hey guys, I'm sorry for making videos late, but I've gone back to video, and this time we're catching up with the React and native mobile apps development from scratch still again. So I just want to start up with a simple show for you guys today on this new video. I'm going to be working with you shortly. I'm using my Expo, and I'm using it from my PC, and which I can show my phone, but definitely when you do this, so you should be in a position to. No, so this is it. Just a simple. I've been just trying to use some simple mobile application, and I'm trying to use Expo to come up with. I'm just going to cancel this for now so that I can start the server from npm start, so that I can launch it from you guys on your point. Now the app I'm trying to make is just some simple app that I'm trying to come up with at the moment. Just some simple app around. So Expo is going to launch for us this app of ours from our command. So I'm just going to launch LobW so that I can launch from my web, which definitely is going to give us a chance to have the app. Now, when I'm using it from my phone, I can actually proceed with the app and I can see it working up. It's just some simple demo app, which I believe you guys might be already having a clue to see how it actually works out. So this app is so simple to deal with, just simple demo app. And if I go to smartphone inspect element on smartphone version, whereby I think if I click the smartphone and I select the phone I want to use, I may say you want to use Galaxy. Okay, that's it for now. If I click there, I think you can see that's ID number 0. If you click there, that's number 2, number 1. And if you click here, that's definitely that. So it's a simple, simple app like that. So to come up with this type of app, this is it. I define my class inside my app. There's nothing yet I've happened to upload. I just define list. This can be anything. It can even be OSP, you get? Like, it can even be OSP. And then this can be the name of the stuff you want to give here. So it just matters what the name would you want to give around there. You can rename always, there's a name here, and you can always give it the name you want. So if you do save that, it will definitely match to that. So, yeah, so if you try to cross-check that, that's it. So in a simple term, this can always be anything else, but I don't want to confuse you. Because this is just, I'm trying to list up my content, and I'm trying to work with the list here. So this is just going to be list where we're trying to just come up with a list of our content of this very app. So if I go further, I just import something called Touchable so that I can click on my screen when I touch. No, so remember, Touchable is a component from React that when you click on it, definitely give us a chance to work with our app on the way we want it to be. Now here down, I just define my stuff. This is a state. This is a state. This is names on my step. So this is a state, and I'm going to be calling it. This is like array of my content, which can be from either database or whatever. This can be just a list of your content that you're passing to an array. This is an alert, which I'm trying to just create alert from there, and I'm trying to alert here. So if I don't want alert ID, I can write alert names because I'm having a name, this is a name. Those are the parameters I'm passing. You can even pass another thing. Like maybe there you're trying to pass a name. You can even pass maybe age. Maybe the age is 20, it's 20, blah, blah, whatever you want to give in there. You get? So you can also just try to copy here. I do that, the same thing there. Maybe it's 12. I can also come back here. Maybe it's 30, whatever. You know, I'm just trying to pass in there the age. So it's always up to you. Maybe that person's also 32. Yeah. So that, this is 32. So if you just expected that, so you can also just give it somewhere here. Okay, that's good for that. Yeah. Oh, you can also give here, maybe this is 23 or 24, whatever. So if I save this, I can always say I want to pass the age here. And definitely if I pass the age, that's the parameter I'm trying to give there. So here I say key item. So key by key is like when I log from which item. So that's it. And then here I'm passing up the airtime property, which I'm calling that. So here I'm passing the item, which is a complete name, and I'm trying to round it there or route it there. Then I'm passing up the style, which is definitely that simple CSS, which I believe you guys should be having a clone. If you're new to this, please can always subscribe down to my YouTube channel. Each time I post a new video, you can always be notified. And then if I hope yes, everything moves up well. When you click there, you can see edge is 12. When you click there, blah, blah. If you can do this, you can even just render the edge unnamed, like alert item. So edge, And then we also have the name, like maybe age, and then item, which I also trying to register this time, maybe the name. So this definitely gives us a chance that based on what you have given, we have the age that you have rendered there. And then remember here, if you check, sorry for that. If you check, this is it. This is where we pass the name. I'll show you all the scenarios where you can track a name and age, whereby you can define a variable and then you pass it inside your props. And then definitely if all goes well, it should work out for you as expected. And so things can, I think you can see. And when you try to rot there, that's just a simple app. And I expect to work for you guys. Thanks for watching this short video. Thank you.